Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Belbina, and today I have this beautiful glam for you. It's the holidays, it's time to bust out these beautiful glams that I have. This was actually inspired by another makeup artist that I follow on TikTok. I'll have to find her name and link it in my description, but so far I have forgotten her name. I used some pearls and some rhinestones and I am feeling myself. So if you are interested in seeing how I created this beautiful look, I would love for you to stick around and keep on watching. Hey y'all, so let's get into it. The first thing we do is the brows. So I'm going to create my shape, fill in the brows. That's basically it. I'm going to make sure that it's nicely filled, nicely shaped, and then I'm going to go in with my spoolie. I'm going to blend out these edges, make sure that it's also looking seamless and kind of natural, but not that natural, because we all know it's not my natural brows. But we're just gonna make sure that we blend out the hairs with the product so that it could be really nice and seamless. Then going in with my LA Pro Concealer. I think this is in suede. I'm going to use this to clean up under my brow bone. And then I'm going to go on the top with Toast, just because it's closer to my skin tone and I don't really like the halo effect over the brows. Once that is complete, I'm going to take Fawn in LA, the same concealer, and I'm just going to spread this all over my lid. I'm going to take a blending brush and I'm just going to blend, not all the way down on the lid, but I'm going to make sure I stay just a little bit above that, because I want to, you know, add more product later, because I'm going to do a cut crease, so I don't want to, you know, put product over the whole lid, if that makes sense. Next, I'm taking both these palettes from Juvia's Place to create my look today, and we're going to start with that dark brown and then go in with some gold and a little bit of burgundy for the look today. So here I'm going in with that first color and I'm going to place it right on the outer edge of my eye. I'm going to create my shape so we can start blending and, you know, meshing those colors together. You know I love blending. I always preach about blending on my channel, so this is a self-explanatory section, so I'm just going to let you watch what I do. As about now, yeah, just watch what I do and make sure you are blending products. I decided to go in with a little bit of brown for that section just to feather out that shade when I am blending, and sometimes you really want to, you know, use a transition color to feather out your edges. So yeah, continue watching what I do and I will be right back.
Thank you.
So now I'm satisfied with what I've done. I'm going to clean up under my eyes, just at the top, the very top of my cheekbones, I guess, because you know there's fallout from, you know, working with eyeshadows, and this is one of the reasons I like to do my face last, because of this right here. You know, I wiped off a little bit of my moisturizer, so I'm just going to reapply my moisture and then just pat it in with the tippy tops of my fingertips. Going in with two of my drugstore products, I'm going to mix them to get somewhat my shade. It's not really my shade, but you know, once I do the do and I fix it up, it's going to look like my shade. But for now, let's just look like a boiled egg and just done the story. For some reason, I don't know if it was the brush or the makeup that smelled a bit funny, or me leaving it out to dry or something. I don't know, but it kind of smelled weird. But let's move on. So I'm, you know, covering all of my imperfections as I usually do, but you can still see my little bumps, which is okay because I have textured skin, I have acne. So, you know, makeup is not going to cover everything. It's just going to, you know, highlight what is already there. Does that make sense? Going in with two of my favorite, I'm going to apply fawn first, and then I'm gonna go in with creamy beige in the corner of my eyes, because you know I want to have that gradient when I blend. So I don't want to have my whole face, you know, looking really white. I want it to gradually look really, really blended. Going in with my brush first, then I'm gonna go with a beauty blender. That beauty blender wasn't working out, so I had to change it. And then I'm just gonna use this and pounce all over the face, make sure everything is nicely blended. Don't be afraid to make the faces. Please make the faces. This is how you're going to get a flawless application, especially under your eyes. Please make those faces. I don't care if you look like a baboon. Yes, you. I'm talking to you. Make those faces. After we have, you know, beautifully blended out everything to our liking, I'm gonna go in with my airspun powder, my translucent powder, and I'm going to set under the eyes, make sure everything is nice and well set good, like the ice in a freezer. Taking my deep mahogany from the NYX Press Powder Collection, I'm going to use this to bring back some definition to my face. We're going to warm up the face, we're going to snatch the face, we're just going to, you know, give me that that I'm looking for. I love this step because I love to actually contour using a powder. I don't really use the stick, sometimes I do, but I like the powder contour than cream. Taking that same powder, I'm going to lightly dust my nose, give myself a really nice shape on the nose. We're going to contour the nose and then go in with some highlight just on the tippy top and on the nose bridge. This blush that I'm using right here is actually an eyeshadow from the Nubian 2 palette, and it is my favorite. I am almost hitting pan on that eyeshadow, and you know, sometimes you just gotta make it work with what you got. I am buying up a lot of blush because I have a lot of palettes that I can use a blush, you know? Next, I'm taking some setting spray and we're just gonna set the face as I continue my look today. Here I'm showing you the inspiration for the look. I didn't really do the eyeshadow itself, but I really liked the design with the rhinestones and the pearls. So, you know, I just wanted to put my own twist to it, and yeah. I don't think she had any rhinestones, but I want to add some rhinestones to mine because it's a recreation of a look, so that means you don't really have to do it exactly like how it is. So yeah, I'm just adding my little twist onto this look because my name is Abina and I do what I do when I do it. You feel me? Looking hot. Let us add some lashes. This is also a no-name lash brand that I got off of AliExpress, so please not ask me where I got this because I don't know the name, but I probably have a link. I think, yes, I actually love these lashes, and when I am actually, you know, doing a look for YouTube for my channel, I would bust these out because these lashes are like so glam. Nah, who this? What a girl look good. I mean that. Anyways, I'm just going in with some of that dark shadow that we have on the top. I'm going to just layer it onto my lower lash line to complete the look. Here we have a lip combo of the day. I'm mixing two of my favorite pencils. We have the dark brown and the light brown, and I'm basically just going to go in and overline my lips with the dark one first and then do the same thing with the light brown over the dark that we use, just to get the desired look and color and shape that I want. Then I'm gonna go in with a beautiful lipstick that I have. I think it's from Maybelline. And I'm gonna use this as my nude shade today, and then as you can see, it kind of overpowered the lining of the lips. So what I did was I went back into one of my eyeshadow palettes and I used some of the brown and I just kindly, you know, neaten it up a bit, and then boom, I added some lip gloss, and that is the look for today. That's it. Just like that. We're done. For more videos like this, you can go ahead and like, comment, and also subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. Also, hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I post a video. I love you.